Hey again everyone, it is Wirky here with a new review. This time it will be a full review of a game I played recently on stream. I'll link the playlist to it at the end, but as always, I won't go into detail on the story and the gameplay will be from the first stream of the game, so within the first part of the game itself. So what game are we talking about today? The game we're talking about is Children of Silent Town. As you'll know from the title, it isn't really a surprise, is it? Everyone knows I love myself a good point and click game, so when it was released a few weeks ago, I jumped at the chance of playing it on stream. The art style screamed at me, and I just couldn't let the opportunity go past. I'm going to start with the positives on this game, because there are a bunch of them, but if that sounds ominous to what is coming, then yeah, it probably is. The story of the game is interesting. You play as a girl called Lucy in a village surrounded by forests, and it is up to her, and apparently only her, to find out the truth of the mystery going on around them. Lucy is a fun character to play as, and her interactions with other characters are interesting. Unlike other child protagonists, she does come over as being an actual child, but without being annoying. She's curious and she's quirky. Her personality is fun, and she genuinely wants to find out what is happening. All of the characters around her are interesting, from her mother and father to the other kids in the village. You don't really ever get to know too much about most of the other characters other than Blue, but the little you do find out is interesting enough. The village is full of mysteries and full of people you never really get to know much about, other than they are all scared. And to be fair on the game, that was pretty much explained right off the bat. The opening cutscene talks about people being too afraid to see sense, and that is all the game really wants to portray, the fear people have of the unknown, and how it is easier for them to hide away than to find out the truth. But that ends up really leading to the biggest negative the game has. The entire game feels like it builds up to some huge revelation, some big twist in the story that will make your head explode when you figure it out. What actually happens is the game just kind of ends. When it feels like the gameplay is just ramping up and we're about to go on into a new phase of gameplay, it just ends up being the end of the story. What's worse is there are four endings and none of them really tell us anything. You can infer from them what the story wants us to know, but you are left with all the mysteries that you had before and a bunch of new questions, and the game doesn't even attempt to answer them. It basically goes from people are still too scared to see the truth, to they decide they will see the truth, but we're not giving the truth to understand anyway. All these really interesting characters kind of just go to waste. You never really get to know them or the threat that they have surrounding them. The one character I'm especially sad he didn't go into more detail about is the crazy old lady. We do get to see who she is, and you get this feeling that the village was more than happy to just block her into her home and leave her there, but that's it. You never really see anything. The game wants you to imagine a bunch of things and fill in blanks that they left, and that is all fine and well if the ending of the game at least felt like it had completed the main story. But it didn't. This is made twice as sad because the game is so freaking beautiful. The art style is wonderful and it makes the game with some really dark themes adorable. Lucy's nightmares between chapters are actually kind of spooky in their own way, but it always keeps that cute Tim Burton-esque feel to it. Characters look amazing and the world around us is dark and sad, but also peaceful. It is a lovely area to explore, but there isn't much of it. It isn't a huge area, you don't really ever leave the village, and after walking around for so long on the same few screens, it doesn't get boring, but it doesn't inspire you to want to revisit it time and time again either. Which leads to its own problem, that the four endings you have to unlock, you have to do on New Game Plus, instead of being able to just reload a save file and get different endings. I think after getting the three endings with the three songs you get at the beginning, you then unlock the fourth song. Maybe the gameplay changes a little at that point, but I have no interest in going back into that world anytime soon to play the same game with no real difference three more times to get an ending I now know isn't all that great anyway. Maybe there are small things worth playing it a few more times, but the game gave me no great trust in them to make it any less of a disappointment no matter how many times I go through the game. That isn't to say the game is bad at all. Gameplay wise, it's a solid point and click game. I like the addition of the songs and the mini games that go with them. The puzzles are simple enough to get, and I really enjoy trying to find the secrets around the world. It has all the wit and charm the genre is known for, with some really sweet moments. The songs are used sparingly throughout. I really enjoyed the button puzzles more than the tile moving one. The way thoughts were shown as pieces of cloth was really nice, and stitching their memories back together had nice symbolism. But like everything in the game, it was nice at face value and empty beyond that. It got a lot of things right, but it failed on one thing that point and clicks really need to be good at, and that is telling a well thought out story. Endings to games can really leave a sour taste, more so than beginnings. If you can get through anything at the beginning and wade through crap in the middle, as long as you're rewarded at the end, you don't mind. Children of Silent Town had the opposite in that I felt like I had a really good start, enjoyed the middle immensely, then the game just stopped and the ending left a bad taste. It didn't make me want to replay it, it didn't make me want to do much other than uninstall the game and put it out of mind, and that really was upsetting because up until that point I was having a really good time. It had a unique feel to it and it just felt like it was getting started. As I said, if there is more to a second or third playthrough, then you have to at least make me want to play the game a second or third time. Nothing in the first playthrough screamed at me to play it again. It just felt like I would go through the motions to get pretty much the same outcome. In the end, Children of Silent Town was just disappointing. This isn't to say I wouldn't recommend it. It is still a fun point and click adventure with an interesting art style and some fantastic moments. Maybe you'll like the endings more than I did. For Children of Silent Town and me though, that is the end. I have my VODs of my playthrough up if you would like to see them, and as always, I stream 4 days a week over at twitch.tv/awarka89. Twitch is my main focus, so please feel free to come and join me over there if you want. I would appreciate to see you there. We play lots of games and a whole bunch of point and click games, so if you like the genre, come over and say hi. I'll be back in a few days with a Valentine's Day special, hopefully, if I manage to finish in time. But till then, thank you as always for watching, and bye bye.